Meanwhile, there's a dragon in Dawnstar. So I'm just taking pictures with the dragon in the sky. I don't think it's gonna fly away. I think it's just waiting for us to show up. Because it wants me to watch it destroy Dawnstar. And nothing I can do about it, because I don't have Dragon Ren. But if my companions can get the thing to land, then I can whack it on the head with my stick. My stick of doom.
Did you hear that noise? I wonder what it was.
I was hoping the dragon would swoop in and eat the troll for us. No. It tasks me. Okay, it has our attention now. We've arrived.
Why don't you crawl back into the egg you came from?
Ooh, it's going after some bandits. Good choice.
Come on, show me how brave you are.
Let them kill the dragon. I don't have to do nothing. They're in panic mode. Lucky hit. Oh, someone just got chewed up. If a giant shows up, then my game's gonna crash because this dragon could have been spawned along with a giant to do battle together. Just for looks, you don't really have to, you're not supposed to interfere with their battle going on. But I don't see the giants. Because once the giant shows up, it's too late. The dragon's already been fighting someone else and then the game crashes. And I don't remember if this crashed my game or if we actually killed this a dragon. Okay, now where is he going? Shoot it with arrows so it can land, so I can whack it with my knife. My giant knife. Ooh, staggered it in midair. There we go. Well, I don't need to use my stick after all. Who got chain lightning in the front of that thing? Nice shooting, Tex. Oh, it's just an Imperial stood in the way. M5 tie-in. He was just in the way. I was waiting for the whole town to come rushing up to the dragon. Is it really dead? But they've all run indoors because there was a dragon in town. So there's no one outside to see anything. Let's go pay a visit to the bandits up here. See who's still crawling through the wreckage up here. Man, these bodies are already getting ice cold up here. Well preserved, they'll thaw out, and then what happens? There should be a mod called Thaw Out. Your character wakes up from an ice age, a glacier cracks open and you come stepping out. You've been frozen forever. And you're from another time. You're from the first era or something. That's your character. Anyway, I should check and see what Elder Scrolls 6 is up to. If they've announced the release date yet for it. And if they've announced if it's anything like Skyrim. Is it going to be Skyrim 2? Or is it going to be more ESO crap? Which I don't care for. I don't want multiplayer Skyrim. So I'm curious how your character begins life as a prisoner. No memories of what happened before their past life. And has to do with the Emperor. They're going to meet the Emperor during the game. And what else? You know, that kind of stuff. Now, according to the little video, the little six-second long video they released a couple weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, it seems to be the area
Look over there.
Near High Rock and Hammerfell, they say.
You okay?
So a lot of Bretons, a lot of Red Guards. What happened? Meanwhile, I don't know what was saved, what wasn't, but I thought I'd go look for my troll. Because when I turned my back, the troll wasn't behind me. And I was coming over here because I wanted to see the level of detail pop up as I approach this ship over here. It went from a box shape to a ship shape. And then I shouted a mud crab inside, into the floorboards of the ship. So now it's in the ship. I don't even know if I can get to it. So I was curious, how do you fight a mud crab that's inside the model? Because if I go on the door of the ship, I'm in a different whole other world space. Don't even try it. You're not even gonna... It's in the floor. It's in the model. It's... My camera can go through the floor. I'm not seeing any mud crab on the outside of the ship. It's inside the ship, I'm telling you. I shouted it through the floorboard. There it is. How are we gonna kill it? How are we gonna even get in there? Oh. No one's allowed in that part of the ship. Anyway. I mean, maybe it will spawn with me if I go through this door.
Come on.
What's in here? Anything? Oh, there's a chest. I don't think I've ever even been in this room. I usually go down this room here. Oh, I'm clipping on something. I'm stuck. I don't want to die on the steps of this place. Oh man, it's so crowded in here. Oh. I don't want to come back out. Oh well, did the mud crab come outside to meet us? Or is it still inside the ship? Oh, somebody kill this thing. Otherwise I've got a red dot I have to take care of. I guess it's ignoring us now. Trying to head over to kill that guy in the cave. Come see me when you're bored, stranger. That guy. I'm gonna go murder him. He's in a cave all by himself because I've already gone through that cave twice on murder sprees. So there's no one in there except for him. If I could remember that, I would try to do his quest first. That way, the ship, everything inside the cave is populated with all kinds of people, including him. That'd be so cool. But I always do this lighthouse thing near the end of my playthrough. So there's nothing left to kill inside that cave except for him. What are those guys called? Blood Marauders or something? They're pretty much extinct by the time I get to the lighthouse issue.
Strange.
Incoming! I think you can outswim a slaughter fish. The deep lake, I mean deep ocean of Skyrim. Are we there yet? My stamina is slowly disappearing. My arms are getting tired. Is there like a way to coast and you don't have to swim? So now when I come out of the water, my arms are going to feel like lead. That'll be fun. Yeah, mods like hypothermia, what they do is when you're in ice water, your stamina goes way down and it stays down until you get warmed up again. Or your clothes get dry. You know, one of the two. I liked hypothermia a lot. Unfortunately, it interfered with a lot of my other mods I have that interfere with stamina. So you gotta pick the kind of game you want to run, and what kind of stamina challenging game do you want your Skyrim to be, and just use that one mod that affects stamina instead of bolting on all these mods that all mess with the same attributes. And then you wonder why your game's acting all crazy. Let's do this! I'm all prepared to kill all the what are they called? Blood Horkers or something? Blood Marauders? I don't remember what these things are called. But yeah, my suspicion was there's not going to be anyone here. Nothing here but coin purses and torches, sconces on the walls to take. That's about it. So I installed wearable lanterns 3.0B. It's always worked for me in the past. I saw that there was a new version of it. It's more compatible with Frostfall and Campfire and all that nonsense. I don't use those mods, so I don't care. And I was looking at the comments. So many people are having issues with wearable lanterns. What happened to it? It used to just work. Oh, there you are.
First you murder my sister, then you massacre my men.
Oh, that's neat. He force greeted me.
To oblivion with your loot. This ends now. Time for you to die.
I'm just gonna play with him. Is he really tough?
No more. I yield.
Oh, I like that. He's faking it. He's faking it.
No more. I yield.
Sure enough, he does. He does that hiss thing. I like when he does the hiss. I grew tired of his hissing. But yeah, I like how he's like, I yield. And then, sure enough, he turns around and does a sucker punch on you with his knife. Usually I shoot him from afar with an arrow. You know, just a one shot. This is the first time I actually got close to where he spoke to me.
Yes?
That's neat. That is neat. I need to stop killing people from far away. I need to, like, see if they have any last words before I kill them. Before I bring you down! Come see me if you're bored, stranger. I always run into the bathroom, I don't know why. I'm trying to get to this hallway here. Yeah, there's nothing here. I need to remember to do the lighthouse quest first. Do it first. Don't come in here until after doing the light quest. Or the lighthouse quest. Then this place is populated. And there's more of a sense of, I don't know, purpose in life when you're murdering those that have relevance. Instead of coming in here randomly and just killing people and not knowing who they were and then You're like, oh, it was those guys. So this is my third or fourth time coming out of the cave. Each time I had to handhold each follower out the door, because for whatever reason still, after all the updates, all the bug fixes, I can't have followers leave the cave. I have to move them out here one at a time. I probably got dirty edits for all I know. You know, you download a mod, it edits the cave exit for some reason at that location when it doesn't need, when it has, the mod has nothing to do with that cave. So I probably keep installing that same mod, and it keeps installing the same glitch on the cave exit. Did you know how some of these Skyrim editors, not editors, but the creators for Skyrim mods, some of those guys, right, and gals, what they do is they start modding their Skyrim, right, and then they think to themselves, hey, I should release this as a plugin file on Nexus, but then they don't remember every little thing they've changed in their Skyrim before they make the plugin. So they call it something like Purse Dog, Purse Dogs of Skyrim. So you're thinking, cool, this mod adds Purse Dogs to Skyrim. How lucky can I be to find this in the hot list? I'm downloading and endorsing before I even give it a try. As long as I wait for my 15 minutes before I can endorse it. Anyway, you got those kind of people, right? Then, about a week later, you start getting the messages saying, hey, why is Ulfric walking around naked? Apparently, the editor says, Purse Dogs of Skyrim makes edits to Ulfric, so he's naked? Is that right? And then the person who wrote the mod's like, I don't know, it works okay for my game. I don't know what's wrong with your game. Anyway, that nonsense goes on and on. You know how it goes. My least favorite mods are the ones that ignore the official bug fixes, you know, the official patch, or the unofficial patch. So we install this really fantastic mod, thinking, oh, this is going to be so great. Then you find out it undoes all the fixes that the unofficial patch puts in. And you're like, what the crap? Like, why do I have this bug in my game again? Sure enough, you find out, oh, I installed a mod that totally ignores the fixes that the unofficial patch does. I found the dead guy. My body sinks to the bottom, so it's really hard to find somebody. When they fall in the water, they sink. Nothing floats. I was debating where to go now, but I thought, you know what? Since we're out here, let's go visit Serana. She's been waiting for us at the castle for who knows how long. To go visit her mother. Something about the courtyard she kept talking about. We'll avoid the whatever that place is called. Something Tears. Tears of Joy. I don't know what it's called. Maybe it's not called Tears anything. Yeah, by now you'd think I'd know all the names of all the places in Skyrim. No. Nope. That's why I have a map. So I can read what the map says and I don't have to memorize everything. It's hard enough remembering all the town names, but the dungeon names? Oh, forget it. Now there are some YouTubers that memorize all the Dragon Priest names. That's kind of cool, to be able to have that power.
Have you heard stories about the Headless Hands?
You know, those are the slightly autistic YouTubers out there.
Scary,
you know, they read a phone book, then they recite the numbers from it, you know, that kind of thing.
They say that he chops off people's heads? Scary.
I think when I was a kid, the only thing I was famous for was I knew the order. I knew the names of all the 60s Star Trek episodes, and I knew what order they were aired in. Now I just know the names of all the episodes, but I can't remember what order they were originally broadcast in. And I can't remember what episodes came with what season of Star Trek. But I can tell you the names of the episodes, though. Because that's still my favorite Star Trek. And I always remember what the name is when someone's talking about an episode, so that's how I remember the names, because I'm always thinking about the episodes, because we're always talking about the old Star Trek, because it's the best. And no, I don't have anything memorized about Next Gen. I didn't much care for Next Gen until Picard got taken over by the Borg. That's when I started watching Next Gen. Before that, it was just boring. Boring as hell. It was too much Love Boat in space for me.